Hey guys, what is up? It is No Help and welcome back to another video today. If you guys like the video, make sure to go ahead and smash the like button. Today is episode 63 of the Ironman progression, and in this video we will be getting the achievement diary cape. All we have left is the western provinces and we need to get the chompy KC for that, so I'm going ahead and making myself a ton of brutal adamant arrows in order to go ahead and do this. So yeah, if you guys like the video, make sure to go ahead and smash the like button. On with the video. Well, we just hit 1000 KC at the chompies. I think that's it. Now if we go ahead and talk to Rance, we can claim our free hats. Can I have a hat please? You show him your bow and he gives you all of the hats in order to, you know, there we go, the chompy bird hat has been completed. And I guess once we equip this, maybe I'm not sure if that completed the diary or not. It looks like it did some. Yeah, there we go. We're getting a bunch of collection log slots, but claim a chompy bird hat from Rance after registering at least 1000 kills. Now, I understand there's a lot of other hats that we can go ahead and collect from this, which we will probably do in order going for the pet in the future, but we need to make a magic longbow and use a shortcut to get a cape. Now, apparently I can just click this ROP and get an achievement diary knocked out of the way. It was kind of a treacherous journey to get here, however. Now we need to make a magic longbow in Tarwin. Now, is this Tarwin? I guess I just gotta try it, make one. And congratulations, you have completed all of the elite tasks in the Western Province area. Speak to Elid Gnome Child at the Gnome Stronghold to claim your reward. Alright, let's talk to the Gnome Child. This is absolutely fucking massive, man. Let's go ahead and complete this diary. Alright, so completing this diary gives you unlimited teleports to the Piscarilius fishing colony, a 50k agility experience lamp, two chompy birds will always appear when chompy bird hunting. That's going to be helpful for going for the chompy chick. The next little perk is the chance of receiving a chompy chick pet. Slayer points, rewards from task assigned from Neve/Steves are increased to match Durdell. 150 free org arrows every single day from Rance, which is kind of useful, I guess. One free resurrection from Zalra when fighting every single day. Might be useful when I go back to Zalra in the future for skills. And the Western Province Diary will tell you whenever resurrection blah, blah, blah has been used. Of course, not the most useful one in the entire world, but nonetheless, we are complete the entire achievement diary. Alright, let's go ahead and use this nice agility lamp on agility. You'll love to see it. And yeah, just from achievement diaries today, we have gained 200,000 agility experience. Look at that, man. Just from agility. Just from doing the achievement diaries, 204k agility gained. You'll love to see it. Something I never thought I would do on this account is talk to this girl named Twiggy O'Corn and ask for myself, can I get that cape of yours for 99,000? Okay, here's 99,000 coins, man. No way, we just got the achievement freaking diary cape on the Iron Man account. Oh my god, this emote is sick as hell as well. Holy shit, you open the book of all the achievements and then you just fucking do them all. Holy shit, man, a bat appears. Oh my god, this is absolutely nuts, man. The achievement diary cape has been achieved on the Iron Man account. Oh my god, craziness, dude. All right, so we can untrim it as well to make it white or trim it to make it green. And I believe now for the quest cape as well, we can do the same. So we can oh my god, dude, the quest cape trim looks so good. We're on trim it. Oh my god, it looks so much better now. We can trim it to show we have the diaries completed as well. God damn. That's funny. In the bank, it shows Quest Cape T versus Quest Cape. So I guess we're gonna have to kind of switch that around, make them both T. Do I just trim that as well and then make them both T? Quest Cape trimmed. Achievement Diary Cape trimmed. Oh my god. Now, the next major achievement kind of thing I want to do on this account is get all of the music tracks unlocked. Now, I could probably knock this out in a day or two to be realistic, but I do need to go ahead and complete a mimic. So, obviously, I'm going to wait for the future to go ahead and do this. I'm in no rush, really, to get the music cape out of the way. I'm going to be mostly focused on maxing the account now, but just to have this as another thing to go for is pretty cool, to be completely honest with you. Weird thing that I have the achievement diary and the quest cape knocked out of the way on the Ironman. Absolutely freaking crazy. Another perk, by the way, is the achievement diary cape allows you to teleport to any of the freaking masters, man. This is overpowered. I could teleport to Toby right now in Varrock. Let's see where this goes. Right to the achievement diary, people, man. That is freaking really cool. So anywhere in the game that I want to go ahead and go, Karamja, for example. Boom, right ahead, unlimited teleports to Karamja from here for some reason. Where even is this in Karamja? Like, this is cool, dude. So many more teleports that I have, like, unlimited access to just from getting this cape knocked out of the way. It's just nuts. Wow, that's so lucky. We just got, you have a funny feeling like you are being followed. And we just got the Chompy Chick pet at 1036 KC. Wow, that's so lucky. I actually, for some reason, like, really like this pet. So your new pet has automatically been insured. If lost, it can be reclaimed from Probetia. Okay. That's pretty cool. So I guess I can pick this guy up and put him in my POH and never see him again. Time for another massive milestone on the account. We are about to hit 3,000 RD laps in 1 second here. Let's freaking go. Oh my god, 3,000 laps. We have another 290 KXP until 94. Let's knock it out. Alright, so I'm gonna try the Sepulcher. I know a ton of people have been saying, oh, if you need to get 99 agility, go and try the Sepulcher. So I'm just doing a bit of research right now. I need to collect some vampire dust, but this is the first time that I've seen this right here, which is very cool. This broken crossbow is from Settled when he died on his Ultimate Iron Man here, when he was AFK. It's really cool that Jagex actually kind of like added that in the game. So yeah, that's the first time I've been here and saw it since I saw the video, but yeah, very cool thing that Jagex went ahead and did to kind of like put him in the game forever, really. And yeah, don't mind my gear, I just wanted to see what the full diary kind of stuff looked like. It looks pretty freaking sick. Doesn't look like, it kind of looks like RS3 armor, but very cool. Alright, so I've been doing the Hallowed Sepulcher for about, I'm gonna say, 2 hours now, and I highly respect anyone in the game who has full Black Graceful. That is some difficult stuff to learn and go ahead and just do. In the few hours, I only gained maybe 30 to 40k agility XP just because I kept failing so much. It is actually incredibly hard. I only gained 46 of the Hallowed Marks as well. Yeah, I'm gonna stick to the arty course, man. I know that once you master this, it can be a lot better experience, but I just can't be bothered to do it. To me, it's like doing Monkey Madness 2, just constantly. There's so much to look out for, and then you could be having a perfect run, mess something up once, and it ruins the entire run for you. I'd rather just chill at the arty course, watch some YouTube videos on the side. I just, maybe in the future I'll come back here for Black Graceful. But I can't believe the amount of effort that is required. Like, I could AFK Zalra more than I could AFK this. This is just absolutely craziness. Like, it is one of the hardest things I've ever done on this game, to be completely honest with you. I'll go ahead and show you guys the collections or whatever that I've done. If I go to the stats here, I did floor 4 3 times. Yeah, it's been tough, man. I've definitely tried it out here, but I think I'm gonna stick to the Arctic course. Well, another 3 days has passed, and once we finish this nice Arctic lap, it will be 94 agility on the Ironman account. Yep, I'm not doing that mini game. I'm just gonna be running the Arctic laps. See you guys in another week, maybe. All right, so we just did the first Tombs of a Mesquite raid. I don't know how to say it. TOA. It was very, very challenging. I'm gonna say that for sure. And we played it on the easy mode. Whatever this fossil dung, I guess. Yeah, because we did it on the easy mode. Damn, that was really challenging. Honestly, very, very hard. That's all I have to say. I don't know if I'll be doing much of this in the future. Maybe once I, you know, max. But I'm glad I at least got, like, the soundtracks and all that unlocked. Ah, dude. Nuts. Alright, so I just checked it out and made sure we did unlock every single music track for the new raid. Definitely very, very difficult. Very surprisingly difficult, honestly. Especially just being on the easy mode. The people that just do it on the hard mode and stuff, they're good at the game. I remember I said RS doesn't take skill. Yes, it does, my friends. So we actually just passed 4,300 laps at the agility course, and I haven't actually recorded anything for this episode in over a week now. I've just been pretty much editing videos and training agility. The progress is going to be a lot slower now, so maybe in the next episode I will do some smithing so that we can, you know, make an episode in a week or 2 weeks, something like that. But it is taking forever now. The last few levels of agility are going to be obviously the hardest and the very slowest. I actually can't wait to see the marks of grace stack up as well. It's just going to be crazy. Like, every few days I'll go do something else. Like, I'll go do a raids 3 or I'll go do this, and I just deposit them all in the bank. So this is just from this session, obviously, the 152 that I've done in the past like 2 days or so. But yeah, it's very, very slow. Agility is going to be the death of me. So maybe 2 weeks from now we can expect another progress video. I'm not quite sure. They're just taking obviously a lot longer now. I don't want to make it like boring. I want to try and put a lot of good stuff into it. So hopefully in the next episode we'll do some smithing to maybe spice it up a little bit. What's that new mini game called? The Giant's Foundry. We can maybe get into that, do some blast furnace with the gold as well. And I also have some brimstone keys that I need to go ahead and open. Maybe I can do that in the next video, because I know the brimstone keys, they have a chance of giving you gold ore, and I'm gonna need the most amount of gold ore that I possibly can for 99 smithing. But yeah, other than that, that's pretty much all I've been doing is agility. So that's why this video has been taking a little while to come out, and the next one might, like I said, be like 2 even 3 weeks from now, depending on how much progress I can get done. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching the entire video. If you went ahead and watched the entire video, comment 152 down in the comments below. Thank you guys so much, and I will catch you in the next one. See ya later.